श्री गुरु गौरांग गंधर्वी गिधारी श्री श्री राधा विनोद बिहारी ज्योति जय ओं विष्णुपाद परिव्रजकाचार्य वर्जस्तोद श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत श्रील वामन गोस्वामी महाराज की जय ओं विष्णुपाद परिव्रजकाचार्य वर्जस्तोद श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत श्रील नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज की जय नित्य लीला प्रसंग विष्णुपाद श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत श्रील स्वामी महाराज की जय नित्य लीला प्रसंग विष्णुपाद श्रील भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज की जय नित्य लीला प्रसंग विष्णुपाद श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद की जय रूपानुगाचार्य गुरुवर्ग की जय गंगा जमुना तुलसी भक्ति वृंदा देवी की जय ब्रजमंडल छत्रमंडल गौड़ मंडल की जय सर्वाष्ट गिरिराज गोवर्धन की जय भक्ति बिना विनाश सिंह देव की जय भक्त राय प्रहलाद महाराज की जय ग्रंथ राज भागवतम की जय अंत गरीब वृंद की जय समवेद गौर भक्त वृंद की जय गौरे
अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरभक्तिजे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तद्भक्ताय भक्त्या विहीनापराधलक्ष्ये क्षिप्ताश्च कामादि तरंग मध्ये कृपामयि त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वृंदे नमस्ते चरणां प्रव्रजंतमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं दैवायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव उतेति तन्मेतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमां तवैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तन्नय माम चरणं Now you can come with me in Gokul, where Yashoda Maiya has binded Krishna in the mortar.
Grinder mortar.
Now Krishna, Yashoda has went to, again to, what, turning. But his mind is not there. He is some upset. Always thinking about his son. Why he did so? I did so. I should not have done this. But actually I have right. Otherwise he would have been more
naughty.
But again she thinks that I am not justified. He is so soft and so sweet. But I have given him so much pain, not to him, but I have given myself in my heart pain. What to do? If I am going and again untying the rope, Krishna is so angry now, and he will go anywhere else. And I cannot control. So, let him for some time and watch him from there always. What he is doing? But in the meantime, Krishna was, all the boys began to joke with him. And they all were clapping and they are laughing. So Krishna also began to laugh with them. And the tears with black kajal were dried here. So a line from here to all everywhere was done. But now he was somewhat happy. He forgot that what mother has done. Boys told, why not we untie the rope and you should be free? Oh yes, you can do. You can untie. My hands are not going there. So you should try. So all were coming, but not was so tight that they could not untie. One after all, of another, being restless, oh, you cannot tie, I will tie. Especially
Madhumangal,
oh, you are bogus, you have no any idea, I will untie. And he quickly went and giving, pushing all others, and he won. But he could not. Then all began to
laugh.
Also laugh. They were thinking that if Baldev is here, Baldev was here, then he could have untied. And this ghatana,
incident
had not been done, it would be like so. In the meantime, Baldev Prabhu was quickly coming from the house of Upananda Vithar with his mother. And when he entered the courtyard, he saw there are so many boys are playing with Krishna, and Krishna is fully tired with that
grinding motor.
Oh, he became so furious and became so angry. Who has done this? I will give a lesson, I will punish him. And became so angry. His eyes became reddish and his both hands were like
shaking.
Shubal told in his ears, brother, don't be so upset. Mother Yashoda has done it. Oh, Mother Yashoda. Then
all anger glow.
Anger went away at once. Oh,
father.
If mother has done, I cannot do anything. There must be some reason. And then he began to follow Krishna also. When Krishna was thinking, Krishna is all-knowing. What?
Omniscient.
So he remembered a pastime of last so much
millennium, last
that my dear devotee Narada has given cause to the son of Nal and Kuber. Nal Kuber were son of Kuber. Kuber was friend of Shankar, and Shankar is so near and dear to Krishna. So there was a relation. So Narada was also a friend of Kuber. One day Narada was going to meet Shankar or Kuber. Both huts were nearby. So he was going. And in the midway he saw that the two sons of Kuber were playing in a very beautiful pond, quite naked, with so many asparas. Aspara, you know?
Demigods,
wives of demigods. Very beautiful, young, teeny age. All were naked. And they were playing hide, seek, and so many things there. And the two brothers were mad after taking wine so much. They have no lajja,
shame
or anything. They were mad in wine when Narada was going. At once, the demigoddesses, asparas, became simple. And they at once they came out of the pond. and they took their
clothes
and they, in a shame state, they began to do pranam
to Narasi.
But these two persons, the boys, they were so shameless and mad in wine that they began to abuse Narada as well as these girls also. This mad person, knowing nothing, finally came in this sight. And you are so bogus that seeing a person and you have come out of the pond and my every test has gone
away. Gone away.
Come quickly. Now saw that they are like a dry tree. They have no shame, they have no knowledge, intelligence, they don't know how to
respect sadhus, saintly person.
Guruji.
Superior.
Saintly persons.
And superior.
And superiors. They are very near, dear to Kuvai and also Shankar. So I should give a good lesson to them. If anyone does not know the pain of a thorn which goes in the
under soul,
under anywhere, he can give pain to others. Like, we can cut fishes, we can cut goats,
sheep
and cows and so many, only to take flesh of them, meat. But if anyone give a injection, even
needle of
needle also, and then don't. And if you should cut his finger, then, and if you cut half of his this, then he will realize the pain given to others. He will realize if any pain will come to him. So these bogus persons, they don't know. What is meaning of meat? I have told some various times. M-E-A-T, M-E-E-A-T. To whom I will eat, they will eat me. Every actions have reactions. If you will abuse anyone, he will abuse you. If you will give slap, he will give slap. To whom? Flesh you are taking and they will become human body and they will eat you. So you should not take all these things. So these persons taken birth in very rusticated family, highly cultured, educated, very beautiful, very beautiful, so wealthy, these kinds of persons always are in so much abundance that they don't believe in God. They don't want to do bhajan of Krishna. Always they are in false egos. I'm so beautiful, I'm so learned, I've come in so rusticated family, I'm Brahman and all these things.
Wealthy.
So they cannot do bhajan. Never. So I will give an injection to them. Oh, you should go and become at once as a tree. You will turn into a tree. Because you are like tree. I am here. I am your father, mother like, superior. And you are not caring for me. And you are doing so nonsense. So be nonsense like. At once you should be a tree. He was so powerful, his words were so powerful that he began to be a tree. Then quickly he realized the situation and he fell down on the feet of Narada Rishi. Oh Narada Rishi, I never knew that he was so powerful.
Save us.
And I was always immersed in false egos. Now I realize that Krishna mercifully has given this body, human shape, only for doing bhajan. Do I realize who am I, who is Krishna, who is God? But I have misused my all time. Always drinking, merrymaking. So be merciful to me. What should I do? Now I'm going to be a tree. My all sense are art now. Like jad.
Like inert.
Inert. Inert. He told that what I have done, it will surely be
true. Happened.
Happen. Anyone cannot make it false. But seeing you that you are now realizing and you are son of my friend. So I am minimizing this. That you will be tree. Surely you will be tree. True trees. But you will be in Vrindavan. And after some time Krishna is appearing there. And when he will be playing as a boy, then he will touch you anyhow and you will be
liberated.
And that you will have bhakti also, not only liberated. Then he became pacified and now went. Krishna remembered, oh my dear Narada has told like this, so I should fulfill my
devotee's
desire. That is why Krishna was thinking. So Krishna can do, Krishna can accomplish
so many tasks by only one task.
By one task. He is so powerful. So Krishna thought that I should do this. So he told the boys, his friends, that push this motor grindle.
Grinding motor.
And I am pulling. Also pulling. Help me. And we should go out of home.
We shall play there.
So making this tree, the boys began to push and he began to pull. When they came at the end of the house, at the door, main gate, just out of main gate, there were two trees, very, very big shadows, very big branches, and so many thousands of birds taking shelter there. And they were just like from root one, very little difference, narrow escape. So Krishna entered in the narrow lane of the two trees. And boys were pushing, but the motor, grinding motor, become like this.
Stuck there.
And Krishna went out of the trees. Both tree touched the two trees, not Krishna directly. The rope with which Krishna, this vest was tightened. And it was tightened with motor. And motor touched. Like a current. Like current will come from here and from here to here. And if I will touch here, that current will come. So Krishna power came through a rope to motor and from motor to
trees.
And at once the two trees were fell down with a very big
tremendous sound.
Very all breasts began to tremble.
What happened?
Those were anywhere. They ran towards that sound, the false sound, quickly off. Nand Baba was going to take bath in Brahmand Ghat, so quickly he ran towards sound. Yasodama was restless and doing, his mind was not there. She also heard the sound and she became so fearful. Oh, from where the sound came? Is it this sound coming from anywhere where Krishna is nearer? So his heart was palpitating, and with fear she ran at once. All the Brajavasi, all at once came. The boys were playing with Krishna and pulling, and they were so happy and doing some
laughing.
Became
what? Fearful.
Very fearful. But their luck was so, they were so fortunate, the tree were not going to fall down like this.
Direction.
The boil, oh, this side and that side. So there was no harm. But all were doing like this and fearful. Yashoda saw from a distance that, oh, Krishna is in the middle of the two trees, that tree has been uprooted. Oh, if the tree has fallen upon Krishna, then what happened? She could not think after this. And she became like a tree. No sense at all. Dry wood she became. No tear, nothing, no breathing, nothing. That is, she became jar, stambha. And Nanda Baba, what happened? Krishna is amidst the trees, and trees have been uprooted. What happened? So quickly he ran away, and he came near to Krishna, and he saw that he was blended in
mortar,
grinding mortar. Then he was also struck dumb. He saw towards boys, and he quickly went and took Krishna in his lap. He asked Krishna, who did this? In the meantime, the boys were assembled, Krishna friends. Baba, Baba, Baba. Krishna touched the two trees and they were uprooted. And very beautiful two shape of human body, like God is. Very beautiful. Like sun, some rays were coming. And they did parikrama of Krishna. And they began to pray something. And Krishna told something. And at last they did pranam, sastang pranam, and they went to north side.
Direction.
Nand Baba told, oh, these boys are not telling. They don't know anything. How Krishna can uproot these two big trees?
How demigods can come?
I think that any demon from Kansa, instructed by Kansa, has come. And they wanted to kill Krishna. And Yashoda is so
cruel-hearted
and unintelligent that he could not understand. If they had both had been died, then what happened? He could not think more about that. He quickly, Krishna was not, before that playing with boys and pulling and pushing, he was so happy and he was so laughing. But when he saw his father coming, at once he began to weep so loudly, more loudly than Yashoda was. Oh, I should beat you? Should I beat you? So, more than that,
so
long, long breath, tears so much. And when Nanda Baba began to pacify him, he began to more weep. Nanda Baba, from his
chadar,
you know? chadar. He began to
remove his
all these things. And he was weeping so much. Then he told, "My dear son, who has binded you?" Krishna was not telling anything. He repeated, "Who binded you? Tell me, I'll punish them. Who has binded you?" Again and again when he asked, then Krishna told, "Mother has binded." Very
near.
"Mother, your mother? I never knew that she is so cruel hearted. Or she is so cruel hearted that she binded. I will punish." And then he did like this, then Krishna caught hold of
Nandava's
hand. Then he gave a laddu. Anyhow, Krishna took it but not taking. Now he was pacifying some little, and so tears were now
stopped.
Not fully, but and he was doing like this. And he was pacifying on his
back.
Here crossing and also here too. Nanda Baba became so grave. And he saw towards Yashoda with fearful eyes. And Yashoda was not in sense. Only the sakhis were taking care of Yashoda. And they were really reading the heart of Yashoda. So they were so unhappy and worried. They wanted that Krishna should come in the lap of Yashoda. But Nanda Baba now is so
great
that he took Krishna and Baldev on his soldiers. He took Baldev Prabhu on his right shoulder and Krishna
left shoulder.
And he went to Brahmand Ghat in Jamuna and he made bath of two sons, and after that he also took sons bath. And again he took them here and he returned to home.
Kausalya.
And now it was about more than two. There was no cooking in the house of Yashoda now, today. No cooking. Who will cook? All were so much worried. Rohini saw that Nanda Baba is coming with two wives. Quickly he did some
cooking.
But
preparation.
Cooking. Dalia, you know?
Porridge.
Dalia. Wheat.
Porridge.
Grindle.
Grinded wheat.
And it is cooked in water or milk. Or in matta. Matta
milk.
Buttermilk.
So quickly she did. A little, only. And Nanda Baba came. She gave it to Nanda Baba. Nanda Baba gave first to Baldev and then to Krishna.
Alternately.
And when they are satisfied, then he began to take something. Very little. He was so grave. So he took something and he went to outer door.
Drawing room.
Like drawing room. Like this is drawing room. And courtyard was there. In India, there are in everyone's house, especially those who are middle class of persons or very rich, they have two part of their homes. Only in inner part, only ladies will be there.
And kitchen.
And kitchen and everything will be there. And outward, only male will sit. So many male will come. Like a sabha, meeting hall. So Nanda Baba was there. Quickly, sandhya came.
Evening came.
About 7, that he takes something. So,
go salage dudh khao na something.
Now he came to Goshala.
Cow shed.
Cow shed. And he went to a very good cow. And he began to
milk.
Milk. And
directly
Krishna's mouth.
Milk was coming in the mouth of Krishna and Baldev. And he gave some
sugar
mystery
candy.
Sugar candy. White wala. And they took full of stomach, two boys. And then he came again, and now it was about to night. Now all these sakhis of
Yashoda
were so much worry, especially Rohini and Upanand's wife. So many all old ladies came there with Baldev. Baba Krishna was with Nanda Baba. They told Baldev that go and forcibly you should drag Krishna here and we will take it to lap of Yashoda. So Baldev went there to pull Krishna, but now Krishna was so strong that he pushed so much that quickly Baldev
fell down.
Then Rani Maiya is asking to Krishna, Krishna, will you not go to your mother? No. Where you will be passing your night? To whom you will sleep? Oh, with father. Not with mother, no. What you will eat? I will eat
milk and sugar.
Milk from the oats of cows. My Baba will do it, and misery. Then, to whom you play? I play with my dada, Baldau, and Baba, Nanda Baba. You will never go? Never, I will go. Then, Rani Maiya told, and if your mother is like this, what is meaning of like this? If she dies away, passes away, oh, seeing this Krishna, become so
worry.
And he began to weep, mother, mother, and he did his hand like this,
spread his arms,
mother, mother, mother. Then at once quickly Rani Maiya came and he took Krishna and she took it, Krishna, in the lap of Yashoda. Up till now she was like a statue, senseless, but when she gave Krishna in her lap, now she became so melted heart and she began to cry, my dear son, my dear son, and began to weep so loudly that Rohini Maiya and all other began to weep, Krishna, mother, mother, mother. And Yashoda was weeping, Rohini was weeping, all those who were there all began to weep. After some time, when Yashoda was somewhat pacified, he gave his milk to Krishna. And in the meantime, something was prepared. And then, quickly, Nanda Baba was called to take some prasadam. Krishna and Baldev were sitting on the right and left hand of Nanda Baba. Nanda Baba told Krishna, you should go and call your mother. If your mother is not coming, I will not take anything. Then Yashoda was not coming. She was so much in shame. But Krishna went there and he caught hold of her bell and he dragged mother Yashoda to Nanda Baba. Then Nanda Baba took something and also
Krishna
Brahma he gave, and after he left some remnant, the remnant was taken away in Yashoda house and all divided it into
And Krishna was now in the lap of Yashoda. In the night he slept well with Yashoda. So Krishna being Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is playing so much sweet pastime. How? To increase his or to renew his love and affection. So those doing so many things. One kirtan in the night. Jaya Kunja Bihari. And the hearing of pastimes, they are not mortal. There is much more differences between mortal world and transcendental world. So much. These songs, that is transcendental words, in the shape of Hari Katha or Krishna name, if a man has a little honor, little Shraddha there, very little, though he is covered with so much anarth, ignorance, but if he is a little honor, these transcendental words will come through the ears in the devotee's heart. These words are not words. Krishna himself, in the shape of transcendental word, comes in the heart of any person who has some a little fraction of
Shraddha.
Shraddha. And clears whole heart. Makes it pure gradually. And then his Shraddha becomes thick. And then Bhakti comes in his heart. Gradually. And he becomes devotee. All bad habits goes away. All anarth goes away. And quickly he develops his Krishna consciousness. And then Nishtha, Ruchi, Ashakti, first Guru, initiation from Guru. And then Nishtha, Ruchi, Ashakti grows and develops. And Bhava Bhakti and then Prema Bhakti comes. And he gives this body, mind, everything. And then his pure soul, like a Brajavasi, goes in Vrindavan. And he becomes happy forever. So don't hear Harikatha. If saints have come from so many far away, mercifully, but they have a very good chance to hear, but those who are not hearing, what they are? They are killer of their own soul. Never tatarshai upariyamana. Oh, sadhat bhakt sotri mano bhiramat. Kau uttam shlok gunan vadat virajje bina pasuna. Only self killer will not. To kill any animal or to himself is not killing. But those who are not hearing, they are losing their life for lakhs and lakhs births. So we must hear and chant fresh name in this life. It is so powerful. Very quickly it will make you so pure and Shuddha Bhakti will come. So don't neglect. At once try to do bhajan from today. Otherwise we can die tomorrow. No knows tomorrow. So quickly from this evening, now it is evening, or just now we should begin chant Harinam and try to give up bad habits at once. There is a Rasagulla, very good Rasagulla, you know, very Indian best sweet, very good, or Indian Peda, very sweet. But if any poison is given in this and you are so hungry, and you are going to take it, but your mother told, oh, don't take it because it has been poisoned. If you will take, you will die. Will you take it? Never. So, we are like mother and doctors. We are experienced doctor. So try to faith on us. We can cheat him. You can have faith on me and Vaishnavas. They are more
merciful
than mother and doctors. So have a very strong faith on sadhus and quickly try to give up all these things, bad things. No harm you are in worldly life, in marriage life, no harm. You should do all your jobs, but don't cut fishes and animals, and don't take eggs, meat, wine and all these things. And you can do any job. You can leave your friends, your wife, your sister, mother, and no harm. So this is the essence of all the Harikatha. Why this story has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam? This is not a story or
mythology.
Nothing. It is true.
True pastime.
And if anyone will hear, the words will go like Krishna is going. And you will see that your heart has been changed and you are so blissful and happy. So try to hear all these things. If any advanced bhakta hears it, what becomes? He tries to follow, I want to be a mother of Krishna, like Yashoda, to serve Krishna. I want to be like Dham Sridham, always playing with Krishna. I want to be like gopis. And then I want to serve Krishna like gopis. So many cowherd boys are serving to Krishna. Mother Yashoda and so many mothers of Braja and so many fathers are serving Krishna. And so many gopis are serving. Among them, who is serving best? And to whom Krishna is pleased more? Can you tell? Gopis. Why? Why with gopis? Why not Sakhas and why not Yashoda mother and Nanda father will serve Krishna? Because they cannot give everything, all their love and affection for Krishna. But gopis can give everything, their shame, their whole body, all senses, father, mother can give. If he has two sons, he will give half to one and other half. But this gopi can give. Oh, whole self is their love and affection for Krishna. So gopi are most superior in loving Krishna. So hearing all these pastimes, they will have some greed to follow gopis. That is why Srimad Bhagavata has appeared, to give this greed. Especially Chaitanya Charitamrita and the books of Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Goswami. So you try to read it. Throw any qualified Vaishnava. You cannot explain and you cannot understand. Taste Srimad Bhagavatam without any bhakta. You can read but you have no taste. But hearing all these things, so many things are coming. Now, yes, sir. Oh, Namami Nandana. Namami Nandana. Namami Nandana. Namami Nandana. Namami Nandana. Suppose. You are lacking something. You want some wealth. And went to any person who is so wealthy. But if you want that, you should give your whole wealth. And what he has, you want more than that. Can he give? If he has something, and you are begging, first, he will not give you. Also, government has bound on begging. You should not beg. But if you are begging, oh, give me something. And if he has no relation with you, he can give some little one, what?
Ringgit.
Dollar or ringgit. 2 ringgit. Like, 4 brahmacharis took diksha yesterday. And they were like a beggar, going one to another person. And in the last, what was collected, they gave me. Then I saw that 1 ringgit, 2 ringgit, 0.5 ringgit, only. Why? All are here in this world like something lacking. So they want to be. And if anyone wants more than what he has, he cannot give. If I want that, I want crores of dollar, any of you, can you give crores of dollars? By selling your property, you cannot give. But if you want from Krishna, pray to Krishna, anything,
everything,
but yet he will have so much. He can give anything to you. He is so humble, he is so manidata.
Generous.
That anything you want, he will give. Others cannot give. Even Narayan cannot give. Can he give? If you want that, you should give me madhur rasa. Can you give? I want that you should make me the Radhika, Dasi of Radhika, Palla Dasi. He cannot give. Dwarkadhis cannot give. Can he give? But Krishna can give you anything you want. He can give you more than you want. So if we pray, Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam, without praying, everything Krishna will be. And if you are praying to Srimati Radhika, then she will give more than Krishna can give. His treasure is more than Krishna.
More bigger.
If Krishna gives something from the treasure of Srimati Radhika, so if you are praying to Radhika, then he will give anything. More than that you expect. So you must pray to Radhika. For what thing? What? I want to become your dasi. Give me sprinkle your mercy. And give me Krishna prem, Braj prem. Not anything else. But unluckily if you will ask him, I want salvation, liberation, or I want wealth, of easily, quickly, he will give you. So you should pray and hear Hari Katha with a strong will and a strong
faith.
Honor and faith. Once in Mathura, there was a lady, low class of lady. He used to sell fruits, very, very sweet fruits. And he used to go to countryside, in villages, where when boys and children of little, small ages, so he used to tell mango, orange,
guava,
sweet guava,
banana,
and very beautiful apple, ripened, radish and eolish fruits. Oh, all boys coming. Hearing the sound of that
fruit seller
lady, see where, or began to collect and to watch with what?
Greedy eyes.
And they used to tell, Mother, I want to take that fruit. This lady, fruit seller, having heard the name of Nandanandan, that recently Yashoda has given a birth, a very beautiful
child,
boy, and his name is Krishna, and he is so attractive, he is so beautiful. Those who goes to Gokul and she is never
returned,
he cannot take his mind again returned. If he returns, his mind, without mind, he returned, and without her. So she wanted to see that boy. One day she took some fruits full of basket, and she crossed the river Yamuna by a temporary pool. At that time, temporary pool used to be by the branches of trees and banana trees. And she anyhow crossed the river and went to Gokul. For them at that time it was very easy to
cross.
To cross and to go. It was not so far away. Still, from Mathura, crossing Yamuna, only 7 miles or likewise. Easily. We can also go. First you used to go on foot, walking there. But now we cannot go because so much
traffic.
Taxis, car, and so much things has been now invented. So this fruit seller went there and was calling fruit, banana, mango, orange,
guava
like this, and crying. But thinking Krishna, she began to cry like what? Govinda Damo Dharma Dhaveti
Govinda Damo Dharma Dhaveti.
Instead of mango, began to cry loudly, Govinda Damo Dhar and Madhav. And anyhow, he left his hand from the basket. Indian ladies, I don't know here what become, taking so many pots of full of water, 1, 2, 3, 4,
five.
Here also 1, 2, and without giving hands on them, keeping, and they can quickly come. I don't know here, they do. But Braj Gopri are expert in this. So, she was like this, giving her heart, and from her core of heart she was crying, Krishna, Damodar. But whole day he was taking round of Nandavan, but Krishna could not meet her. She returned again, continuously she went there 3 days. Today she promised, if Krishna will not give his darshan, I will not return. I will give up my life. Promising this, she went. And she was so much absorbed in chanting Govinda Damodar that Krishna could not check up himself. He was in the lap of Yashoda. At once he came out quickly. And he saw that there was a heap of grains. Feet. But and with his little hands, small hands he took, like this. And, I want fruit, give me fruits. This fruit seller was of low cost, so she could not enter in the house of Yashoda. She was on the door, out of the door. So Krishna, taking these grains, but grains all
falling down,
came down. Well, if some grains, 2, 3, 4, were there, and Krishna was thinking that, it is full of. And he wanted to give that fruit seller. And she observed Krishna. And she was totally absorbed. And she was looking and looking. He gave her heart to Krishna. And when Krishna told repeatedly, give me fruits. Then quickly his knowledge came. And he again looked towards the face of Krishna. And he at once told that, oh boy, if you will tell me mother
and sit
on my lap, then I will give you. Because you have no grain in your hands. And Krishna saw that, all grain has been gone. But he was looking here and there that anyone is looking or not. And he was fearing that if my mother or anyone of Braj will see that Krishna has sat sitting in the lap of this low class of this lady, then what will be? So he was looking here and there, and he saw that none is here. Then he told mother quickly, and he sat at once on the lap of that lady, and at once jumped up from there and began to talk, you should give me food. She was so much pleased, and he gave some fruits, but only fruit, mangoes and banana was so much for the hands of Krishna. He wanted to give all the fruits in the hands of Krishna, but Krishna's hand was
so small,
small that she could not give. He took like that, two hands, and make his stomach also like one side, and he wanted to take more, so some fruits were given, very sweet. Krishna took it, and dancing like thei, you know, how wild, when they are so much happy, they dance like that, and dancing Krishna went to his mother and gave all the fruits in the bell of Yashoda. And she began to distribute, and she became so happy. But fruits were so endless that he began to give to all the gopis. And they began to increase. So all were given, but still the fruit was there. And what became of that fruit seller? When Krishna came from her, and he came to over his side, then his mind was and heart was taken by Krishna. So without heart and mind she was there. For so much time she was sitting there. Anyone came, and why you are sitting here? Anyhow, he what did?
Sick.
And then he took his basket on her head, and she was going to her home. When she came on the bank of Jamuna River, he felt that my basket is so heavy. Why so heavy? So he
put it down
and saw that it was full of jewels. A jewel was so costly that the khajana of Kansa,
treasure of Kansa,
whole gold, will be not able to be equal to one jewel. So it was full of so much jewels. She told that, what is the use of now jewels? She fell down all in the Jamuna.
Throw the jewels.
Like a man, Govinda Damo
Dharmadhaketi, Govinda Damo Dharmadhaketi.
She did his hand like this, no? Govinda
Damo Dharmadhaketi, Govinda Damo Dharmadhaketi.
No bell. Bell came out. It was going on earth. She had no sense. Only sense of Krishna was there. Tears were coming so much. Heart was so melting.
And after this, anyone could not see where she had gone. He never returned to her room. Where's his name? Can you tell?
Krishna
said, oh, she is like to be my mother. Quickly he took. And his body was lying down on the Jamuna side. Someone came and gave it to her. And she, very beautiful, like a mother, went to Golok Vrindavan. If you want to follow that link, very easy to come. So Gurudev has come to give this thing, speckle this thing. You cannot repay him by worldly worth, reputation or anything. You have nothing to give, repay Gurudev. So you should think, you understand the glory of Gurudev. How he wants to give you that same wealth that Krishna gave it to whom?
Fruit sellers.
Fruit sellers. So try to be like that. Don't waste your time. Don't waste your human body. At once you should try to be like that. Always be in this way. And singing what? Govinda Dhamo. Not like a song. Praying Krishna with heart, core of heart. Then Krishna will hear. Otherwise, yes, you are singing like Sangeet. Sangeet means song.
Music.
Krishna cannot hear your music. He knows so many music. From his nail, so much music can come. His inferior devotees can sing so much. So try to pray like this, core of heart, and Krishna will hear. So any kirtan you do, you should be absorbed into it. And do it. Otherwise, if you are doing sangeet,
music,
oh, Krishna will not be satisfied, he will not see you. But if you are chanting, remembering like this, then Krishna will hear and at once come and give you his wealth. Krishna 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 Krishna
Krishna
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 H
Thank you.